Are you running a nonprofit organization or corporate social responsibility program in multiple countries or locations? Are you still collecting stakeholder data on a piece of paper? Are you looking for more efficient ways to streamline your data? If you want to set up a continuous impact measurement and management process right from the data collections point, then you are in the right place. It's alarming to see so many organizations still collecting stakeholder data on a piece of paper, then manually transferring the data to Google or Excel spreadsheets. Additionally, they have to take this data to analytical tools so that they can then prepare a report to their funders. Increased errors through transcription and late detection of inaccuracies lengthen the reporting time and make the process complex and unreliable. In the 21st century, we have access to so many powerful technological tools that can allow us to streamline and improve the efficiency at which we operate. While we empathize with the various different ground realities that might have forced the organization into a paper-based data collection process, we believe that there are better ways. You can make data collection efficient, reliable, and less energy consuming. Before we dig deeper, let's determine why organizations will use paper-based data collection. There can be a lack of internet infrastructure at the data collection sites, a lack of awareness of offline data collection tools, lack of expertise to collect data on said specialized tools, a lack of resources, or a lack of intention. If your reasons are between numbers 1 and 4, we strongly believe that we have a solution for you. But if your reason is number 5, then unfortunately, it's beyond the scope of this video. So let's explore how you can set up your continuous offline data collection process, because data collected efficiently can fuel the continuous impact measurement and management process. Here are 4 steps to consider while moving from paper data collection to continuous impact learning. Firstly, what type of data are you collecting? Before selecting a data collection tool, understand the type of data you'll need. This crucial step will impact what tool to select, how to analyze, and learn from the data. So, stakeholder data, who are your stakeholders and how are you reaching them? Are you collecting data from different types of stakeholders? For example, students, families, and teachers. Do you need a separate survey for each of them? Do all of them need an offline solution? Are there any language, technology, or resource barriers? Then we have progress data. Do you want to measure progress over time? To demonstrate the change, organizations want to measure progress over time. In this case, it makes perfect sense to have stage questions. For example, the baseline, midpoint, and post-pivot, indicating what happened before, during, and after the intervention. Are there multiple locations? Are there many people collecting data on the same survey at different locations? If this is the case, is there a need for multiple data storage locations, or is all of the data aggregated and reside in the same location? For simple use cases, collect data in a common location to make life way easier in terms of learning from your data. Secondly, do you need offline data collection? Are your stakeholders residing where the internet is not reliable? If you need offline data collection, there are many applications to choose from. Depending on your specific needs in terms of the capacity of your staff, your budget, the volume of data, you can choose a tool. We at SOPACT recommend Kobo Toolbox. We love it because it's simple, easy to use, and is completely free. If you are cost conscious, we would highly recommend Kobo Toolbox. Thirdly, how can you move from paper-based data collection to Kobo Toolbox? Most organizations think that they need to buy expensive tablets to collect data in offline mode. That is a wrong assumption. There are 2 fundamental ways. One, using a mobile or tablet device if you have them. Or secondly, using a web browser with offline mobile data collection links from your mobile, your tablet, or your computer. For offline collection, create an account on Kobo Toolbox. Create a form based on your paper-based survey, generate an offline browser link to the survey, and finally, use that link to start collecting data. If there is no internet connection, the data gets cached in the browser, and once an internet connection is available, the data can be safely transferred to your Kobo account. If there is the internet connection, the data seamlessly gets stored in your Kobo Toolbox account. And it's as simple as that. Fourthly, continuous impact measurement with Kobo Toolbox and Impact Cloud. Now that you've simplified your data collection, what's stopping you from learning from your impact? At SOPACT, we believe learning from the data should be equally as easy. As you know from our previous videos, you can seamlessly build the impact strategy, select metrics, and get impact insight with Impact Cloud. Impact Cloud is a comprehensive solution that eliminates the need to integrate many tools from impact strategy, data collection, program data management, data analysis, dashboarding, and reporting. Now, you can connect your Kobo Toolbox with the same powerful cloud-based system and bring in your offline stakeholder data seamlessly for continuous learning. Are you ready to give it a spin? Start your impact journey with Impact Cloud today. Well, thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you learned something new, and I'm curious to hear what challenges you and your organization are currently facing when it comes to impact measurement and management. Drop a comment down below and let's get the discussion started. I'd love to hear what you guys have to say on the subject. And if you found this information helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel so you never miss an upload. And until then, this has been Chris Gaines. I'll see you in the next one.